This is what happened to the Scapinglete. Within record 3 years, he gets his PhD.
3 years?
And at the same time, he gets a baby, you know.
Wow.
Yeah. he gets many things.
Around that time.
Around that time.
Amazing.
And God is able to do much as we put ourselves and our lives to him.
That's right.
To direct our path. Because now I can't believe the Scapinglete is able to be now speaking to Anthony.
Amazing.
I mean, you went to school and were class six, you're
six years old.
Me, I'm only 12. You know, surely, how should I be here if it's not God's grace?
And today, you are a professor. I am not a professor. You are a doctor.
Yes.
So after Aberdeen, you did your PhD.
What I did my PhD, yes.
3 years.
Yes.
Came back to Kenya.
Came back to Kenya. Mm-hmm. Came back to Scott. Became a lecturer there.
Right.
Then climbed, you know, this, when you get a PhD,
yes.
You don't become... You don't become a professor,
right?
No, it's a process.
It's a process.
You must be. You must be writing. You must be publishing.
Publications.
You must be teaching experience, and then you have other professors who examine you,
right?
And then they tell you now you are a professor.
Amazing.
But I came back to Scott. I was a deputy principal for academic affairs for several years. Then went to NIST. Now they are called International Literature University. Was there for 6 years,
right?
And within those 6 years, I was also became the deputy principal vice for planning and development. Then eventually went to World Vision, team leader for East Africa.
Wow.
For what they call Christian commitments, supporting 8 countries.
Wow.
So did that job for for 2 years.
Okay.
Then Macedonian Corps. You know, Macedonian Corps is where somebody comes and calls you, tells you, please, we need you, come.
Right.
This is what happened. Went back to Scott. In 2010.
Wow.
2010.
Mm-hmm.
And then my good friend retired, the principal that time.
Mm-hmm.
And then people were interviewed, you know, books were opened. Scapinglete
became
the vice chancellor.
Wow.
The vice chancellor of Amazing. Scott Christian University.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
And then later on you became the chairperson of the private university.
Yes.
Wow.
This year I was elected. This is Kenya Association of Private Universities.
Right.
So it's a membership society where universities become members.
Right.
We have universities like Daystar, like USIU, Strathmore, and others.
Mm-hmm.
And so in our meeting, NGM, this Scapinglete was elected to be the chair of
couple. Of that. Amen.
And not only that, but this Scapinglete, to encourage your Scapinglete is out there, that you can make it.
Amen.
I also represent the all private universities in Kenya.
Wow.
In the University Council for East Africa.
Amazing.
That is a council for the 6 countries of East Africa, which looks after the matters of university education.
Wow.
Yes.
So, Professor, we need to finish, and I needed to encourage someone again.
Yes.
Looking at your story, where you've come from,
mm.
and what God has been able to put into your hands up to date, I mean, that's such a feat, and we celebrate you for that.
Mm.
But there's someone out there who's probably thinking, can I ever make it? They're probably struggling with school fees. Some of them have not even been able to get to school.
Mm.
But deep down their hearts, they know there's hope for me.
Mm.
I mean, you are there, and today you are here.
Mm.
There's definitely hope that is available.
Yes. And if I can tell you, is that my father did not have money to educate me.
Right.
University money, no. It didn't. In fact, he tried up to Form 6. The rest of it, I have done it myself. And when I say myself, it is God with me.
Wow.
Because I've done work study, I have written to friends, I've written for scholarship. What I tell people, and I, like a vice chancellor, I tell people, don't think about money first.
Mm-hmm.
Think about the studies,
right.
Desire to study, Anthony. If you desire to study now, I'm telling you, and I tell my friends, particularly when I speak to my daughter Malia, we agree that thoughts become things.
Mm-hmm.
You must translate your thinking to reality. What does that mean? You have plenty of friends who can give you even one 1,000 shillings, right. even less. And out of that, you can achieve your dream.
Amazing.
And I must encourage my friend that there's not one time I've had money somewhere so that I got to pull it out. No, I have had to work, even at University of Aberdeen in Scotland, I have had to teach. I was a tutorial fellow. So that I raise
money,
my money.
For your school
even first. For about 6 months, I worked as a night supervisor. You know what that is? In Scotland, night supervisor is a good term. They use it that way.
Right.
In Kenya, they call them watchmen. Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
While you're doing your PhD,
yes,
you
yes,
are actually a
yes.
watchman.
And of course, I left a bit. Of course, when I finished from sixth, before I went to teach, before I went to university, I was a watchman for 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
So I know what it means. I understand. When I see security people,
yes.
I appreciate them. I have been a security person.
Amazing.
I have carried that big rungu.
Mm.
But does not matter what you carry now.
Wow.
You should not keep carrying it.
Mm-hmm.
You should be willing to ask the Lord to help you.
Amazing.
And Anthony, I hope you can allow me to encourage friends,
right.
those who are listening to me, and they have children, they are themselves. Even Anthony, I invited you. I know you're in a private university studying, but when you finish, come to mine.
Oh, come great.
Come to Scott Christian University
uh-huh.
because we have programs. We have programs. Of course, our bedrock is School of Theology,
right.
where we teach people, you know, God's Word and ministry. But mm-hmm. also, we have professional studies where we teach people business, leadership, with IT,
agribusiness,
mm-hmm. or even hotel management.
Right.
And we have School of Education where we teach Bachelor of Education, Masters of Education, even ECDE. And we are on the move,
mm-hmm.
and it would encourage anyone struggling. I know when I talk like this, I go radio show sometimes, and people mm-hmm. send me text message say, oh, nitafutia scholarship, nitafutia scholarship.
Yes.
Don't begin with the scholarship.
Uh-huh.
Apply
right.
to the university.
Okay.
Be admitted. Then we will sort the rest of it.
Pursue that after.
Yes.
Great.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Professor. We appreciate.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time. And
you.
We celebrate you.
Thank you.
You are an embodiment of, you know, the hopeless becoming hope.
Yes.
And someone in society.
Mm.
So God bless you and thank you for encouraging us. We'll be visiting Scott again.
Karibu sana.
Asante.
Thank you.
That was Professor Mumo. Amazing testimony from, you know, a heart's boy. Drinking raw milk to becoming a professor and doing amazing things for this nation and beyond, even in the East African region. And I believe that has encouraged you. Otherwise, thank you very much. We will be coming with Gifted later on, amazing saxophonist right here on Tukuza. So don't go away.